Hikaru, what a fantastic last position and what a fantastic game. Your thoughts?
Yeah, it was a very interesting game. My opponent, Jan Christos, he was trying to play the most challenging line with Queen E1. And we reached this position somewhere around move 22. I think I had prepared it up to this point. And then he played this knight e2 and h5, followed by queen a5, whereas I had looked at like knight e2, rook g1, queen a5, a couple different setups. And I use a lot of time somewhere around here. And I think probably what I did was objectively correct playing knight f4. I think I simplified to where it should have been pretty balanced and even. I just couldn't come up with anything better despite the huge advantage on the clock. So I did that. And then I pretty much was ready to make a draw. But then he played this bishop b4 move. He got a little bit careless, allowing c5. And after c5, I mean, I suspect that it's still probably okay for white. But I mean, when you go from being like completely even, maybe even small advantage, like suddenly having to defend, it's very unpleasant. And he didn't find the right continuation. I mean, he shouldn't have traded on d5, should have played like bishop a5 or bishop c3, something else at least, because it seemed like in the game, once I took f3 and got rook b7, I mean, just the long diagonal really was too much. He couldn't counter all the threats, combined with the fact that I had passed f-pawns as well. So pretty good game, I think.
Right, all reasons to be happy with it. Now let's just talk about your opening choice. We've seen you play the knight off, we've seen you play the dragon. The line you went for today is something that we saw at Wykanze as well, the famous game, Magnus against Gawain. Where did you change and what happened today?
Yeah, well, I played rook b8. I think Gawain played rook e8 in that game, so that's a big difference. I mean, I had already had this idea quite a while before the game in Vike, so I mean, I think I just did a better job of preparing than Gawain did. But it still was quite interesting. I mean, I think it was, again, I think all the moves were the correct moves. I mean, what Jan Christos played, certainly they were the best computer moves up until he played h5, and then then we just were playing on our own. But I mean, I think theoretically it's a very important game, and I mean, it's always fun to play the dragon. I mean, it's a pretty decent opening, so if you can get a win with it, that's always an added bonus.
I was going to ask, how do you decide, or how do you choose? Give us some insight on how do you choose your opening for the day.
Yeah, well, today I just flipped a coin, so...
Literally?
Yeah, I did, actually. I mean, I knew that Jan Christos played many different things against several different openings that I could have played, so basically I just flipped a coin between the dragon and one other opening, and...
You're not going to tell us which one?
Came up correctly, so Fate made the right decision.
Right, now, especially after the position, after Queen C7 in the opening, there aren't too many games on the database. Do you think, like, this game is going to take this theory forward?
Yeah, I think it will. I mean, I think everything was thematic and made sense, like g4, h4, trying to play h5. I mean, that's all, it seems like it's the correct plan. I mean, I think, I suspect knight f4 was not the best move by me a few moves later, but I mean, I know that when I looked at similar setups, like knight e2, queen a5, all this was pretty normal. So, I think Jan Christos played quite well. It's just he got careless for one move, and unfortunately, I mean, he just couldn't recover from it.
Right, and well, brilliant game, Hikaru, but now let's come to another brilliant occasion, which is the Battle of the Sexes tonight. Are you going to participate?
Oh, I didn't know that was tonight. I suspect I will. I mean, unlike past years, I've been pretty quiet this year. I don't think anyone's seen me that much, so I might compete. It depends how I feel in a few hours from now, but it is Saturday, so it's reasonably likely that I'll show up.
A good way to spend Saturday night?
I mean, I would say so, yeah. Certainly, considering the options here, yeah.
Right, and what this, you know, this event, Battle of the Sexes, has been a traditional event for the Tradewise Gibraltar Chess Festival. How do you feel about it?
I think it's very good. I mean, I think the whole tournament in general, the fact that there's so many female players, the fact that Brian and Stuart encourage women players to come and compete here is very important, certainly, because there are obviously a lot more male players, and certainly many more strong male players, certainly, than female players. So I think just everything to try and encourage women to play is very good. And I think, I mean, it's certainly in this day and age, at least, it's very important to try and get women more involved in chess.
So as one of the elite players of the world, one of the strongest players of the world, you support this ethos of having to promote women chess in the way Brian does?
Well, absolutely. I mean, I think you look at some players like Huyi Fan, she's trying to stop playing in female events. I mean, certainly, I think it doesn't matter what sex you are. I mean, you have to play against the best players to improve. And I think having adequate prizes for the female players certainly makes a big difference. And they come here and they try to win, and I think that is certainly a good thing. I mean, again, you have so many more male players than female players that anything to try and make it more balanced is important, certainly.
And well, let's not forget so far what at least appears to be your toughest game was actually against a female player, Valentina Gunina.
Yeah, I mean, if I'd played a little bit better in that game, I probably could have won like 6 hours earlier. But yeah, she defended very well. I mean, I think that was a very critical game. And I mean, unfortunately, she couldn't hold it at the end. But I think, you know, after we'd been playing for 7 hours, really was more just making moves on inertia than anything else. And, I won that game, but certainly credit to her for playing and playing a great game.
Right, well, very enterprising and brilliant play by you so far, and we are really looking forward to see what you bring to the second half of the tournament. Good luck.
Thank you.